Hello world and welcome to a brand new Azure vlog. In my latest video, I showed you how you can connect Azure Sentinel to a Git repository. Within that Git repository, we could define our detections, and with a Git deployment, we can deploy them to Azure Sentinel. In this video, we are going to dive a little bit further into that matter. We are going to explore how we can define an automation rule in Git and have it deployed to Azure Sentinel. So, as I told you in my previous video, Microsoft, or I must say Azure Sentinel, loves Git. We can connect Azure Sentinel to Git nowadays. Within that Git repository, we can store our detections, our automation rules, our logic apps, everything to automate and configure our incident response. In this video, we are going to touch base on the automation rules. So let me show you what an automation rule is and where we can use it for. So an automation rule is there to decouple your incident response from your detection. For example, we can have multiple detections that use the same response. For example, isolating a virtual machine or blocking a user. We can create a single automation rule in it, have all the actions described in there to follow up on that incident and use it for multiple detections. So your incident response is decoupled from your detection logic. We can have multiple scenarios in there. We can use it to automate the incident response, as I said earlier, but we can also use it to forward data to, let's say, another incident response system. We could set up a single automation rule and have all the Azure Sentinel incidents, for example, for being forwarded to a service bus, which is getting read out by another third-party application. We could also use the automation rules for the more complex scenarios of incident response. We can apply multiple automation rules to a single incident, and we can set the priority for them. So if we have a look at an automation rule, it contains of a trigger. Nowadays, there are not that many triggers, but the trigger an incident is created is being used. We can have a condition. For example, the title of the incident needs to match with a string or something like that. We can set up actions, and those actions can be there to manipulate the Azure Sentinel incident. For example, change the status or one of the properties that are tied to the incident. Or we can trigger logic apps for the more advanced scenarios. For example, blocking a user or isolating a virtual machine with Defender for Endpoint. We can set up an expiration date, so we can deploy an automation rule and only have it active for a certain piece of time. This is helpful if you are getting a burst of incidents and want to respond on them automatically. We can set up the order, so we can have multiple automation rules assigned to an incident. And by using the order, we can determine what automation rule needs to be executed first, what to be the second, and so forth. And lastly, we have the status. We can set the automation rule on active or disabled. So what is the reason why we would like to have all those things in Git? Well, that's basically standardization. We standardize a lot by defining our automation and things in code. Scalability, if we define it once in code, we can deploy it to multiple workspaces. And we have a better control on quality. So it's really important to define your assets as much as possible in code. So Let me show you around how things are working. So here we have a Azure Sentinel workspace. And as you see right now, we don't have any automation rule being deployed at this time. It's a empty screen over here with a lot of text on how we can set up automation rules and so forth. If we go to create over here, we can create it manually, but that's not what we want. For this repository, for this Azure Sentinel workspace, I already have a Git repository configured over here. And it's configured to also have the automation rule as content type being defined, which means that when I have an automation rule in my Git repository, the deployment process will automatically pick up that automation rule and deploy it to Azure Sentinel for me. If you would like to know how we can set up this connection, please visit my previous video. I did a deep dive on that. So if we go to the Git repository, and I'll show you around, we have some detections in here, but that's not what we want. Let's create a new folder and call it automation rules. Let's create a new file, automation rule dot, it's JSON actually. And I already have predefined a automation rule on the screen over here. Let's paste it in. So this is the ARM template that we can use to set up our automation rule. So let's quickly run through this ARM template. So we have an ID in there. We have a name, a type of automation rules, the API version. We can define the actions of an automation rule. In this case, we are going to define the property status and set it to close with the classification undetermined and the classification comment unknown. We can give it a display name. So this is the name that will be displayed in the Azure portal. We can set the order and we can set the trigger logic. So we can set the condition over here. And it's currently using the property incident title, and the incident title should start with sample. And then this automation rule is getting executed. It doesn't have a expiration time setup. It currently is enabled, it triggers on incident, and it triggers when the incident is created. So if I go to my changes over here, hit the plus to include it in my stage changes, and give it a commit comment, add automation rule. And if I click on here, it is getting committed. If I go to my GitHub, go to the Azure Sentinel repository over here, go to my actions, we see that the deployment of Azure Sentinel is now running. We can have a more detailed look on it. It's setting up the job. It's now logging into Azure. And that can take a little bit of time. So, and with the magic of some video editing, I was able to speed up this this process a lot. It normally takes about 1 to 2 minutes. So let's get back to our Sentinel workspace, go to the automation panel, and we can see that our automation rule has been deployed over here. We have a trigger condition when the incident is created. We have a title called sample automation rule. We have the conditions that were stated in the ARM template. Title starts with sample, and we automatically close this incident with some classification information in there. We have no expiration date set up. We have set a order of 10, and it's currently enabled. Awesome, right? So in this video, you saw how we can use the power of Git and the Azure Sentinel Git connection to deploy a automation rule. At the moment of the creation of this video, I was not able to find a lot of documentation related to this topic. So I hope this is interesting for you. I hope you learn from it. If so, of course, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to this channel, and maybe I'll see you in the next video. Bye!